darling, yes, Lord, beautiful King, excellent Lord, we bow before you. Glorious Lord, beautiful King, excellent Lord, we bow before you. Oh, glorious Lord, glorious Lord, beautiful King, oh, excellent Lord, we bow before you. Oh, glorious Lord, glorious Lord, beautiful King, excellent Lord, we bow before you.
Hey, hey, hey. My Lord, Jesus, Let's magnify him. magnifying. Let's magnify him. Father, we thank you. Father, we thank you. You are the lady of the valley. You are the rose of Sharon. You are the Aham, the Aham. You are the author. You are the finisher of our faith. You are beginning. You are the head. We worship you. We adore you, O God. We adore you, O God. We adore you, O God. Thou art worthy. Thou art worthy, O Lord. Father, you deserve all the praises. To receive glory, O Lord, and power. Oh, thou art greater. Oh, things are far than pleasures. They are all work. Father, we thank you. We thank you. Father, we bless your holy name. Thank you, Jehovah. 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 Father, we know where you brought us from. We know where you brought us from. Hi. Jesus, we know where you brought us from. Father, we know where you brought us from. Jehovah, we know where you brought us from. Father, we thank you. If it had been before Jesus, where would we be? We know where you brought us from. Father, we thank you. We know where you brought me from. I know where you brought me from. If it had been before Jesus, where would I be? I know where you brought me from. Father, we thank you. If it hadn't been for you, where would we be? Yes, 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 yes. I may be around wasting destiny. I will be around doing what you do in your life. But you took me. Yes, yes, you washed me. You brought me from the fiery clay. You cleansed me to serve you. Yes, sir. Father, we appreciate you. Thank you for my life. Thank you for my soul. Thank you for my family. Thank you for the ministry. Thank you for the ancient, for you are ancient of this. Thank you for people that are serving you. People praying at this hour. Accept our thanks. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Hallelujah. Father, we give you all the glory. We thank you, O God. You are God, there is none like you.
Oh, yes.
Amen. Before we sing that, let's take one hymn to the glory of God. And the hymn is, now thank we all our God with heart and hands and voices, who wondrous things have done, in whom his world rejoices. Amen.
Amen.
Now thank we all our God with heart and hands and voices. Oh, wondrous things have done, in whom His world rejoices. Who from our mother's hand have led us on our way, we can let it come more. Until we are too big. Oh, many times of song, to hold our lives together, we never joy to find. I'm better to together. I keep on singing, and I don't let my heart feel anxious about your ears. Singing for and singing, oh, praise, oh, praise, I dance to God, the Father that I am singing. That's all I'm doing, waiting in high heaven. Lord, my Father, God, whom heart and heaven adore, for the great one did not have to be ever. Oh, how great, how great I thank you, God.
Thank you, Jesus.
To come again at your presence.
Thank you, Lord.
Accept our thanks in the name of
Jesus.
Amen. Lord, thank you for what you did at the 12 o'clock prayer hour.
Thank you, Jesus.
We are believing you will do stronger now in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you for the anointing that you gave us at 12 o'clock hour. We are believing you will give us more anointing now in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you for the blessing you gave us at 12 o'clock. We are believing you give us more blessings now in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you for being awesome at 12 o'clock. We know forever you are awesome. Nothing can change your place. As we come together now to do the part two of what we started earlier, Father, we pray that your name will be lifted in our midst.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
For you will do greater than our expectation.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus. Amen. That the Egyptian we see today, we will not see them again in Jesus'
Amen.
Name. Father, we thank you, our Lord. We thank you, our God. In Jesus' mighty and wonderful name, we have prayed.
Amen.
Amen. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
When we come to church, let's be agile. Don't be just sitting and resting. It's not right. Hallelujah. When we are the house of God, talking to your sister, when you are the house of God, when we are outside, we can hear your voices all around. But when you're house of God, that is where you want to relax. Amen.
Amen.
The Lord bless us.
Amen.
Let's be mindful of what we do. It's not compulsory to be in the presence of God. We can sit down at home and connect. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Let's settle down. Whatever is happening is after everybody is saying it worldwide. So let's be careful. It's not by force we come to the house of God and be sleeping. No. Amen.
Mm-hmm.
We started something before. We're going to continue again. To the glory of God.
Mm-hmm.
Hallelujah.
Mm-hmm.
What we started before was, people on the wall, please let us have comments of what is happening. And people of the world, please always endeavor to mute your phones. Hallelujah. Endeavor to mute your phones, please. When you mute your phones, we can hear what is going on. Amen.
Amen.
The Lord bless you.
Amen.
We started earlier by, amen,
amen,
by talking about the Goliath in our lives. And how the Goliath must fall. Amen.
Amen.
We shall continue. Can I say this before us, that when we talk about Goliath, we all know about the Goliath that fought with David. Amen?
Amen.
But that is not the only Goliath. There are many Goliaths in the Bible. What does this signify? It tells us that the fact that you have destroyed an enemy doesn't mean other enemies cannot rise up.
Mm-hmm.
After the death of first Goliath, many Goliaths rose up. Amen.
Amen.
Many Goliaths rose up. Hallelujah.
Amen.
After the death of the first Goliath, many Goliaths rose up. Where are the Goliaths that rose up? Those are people that will check in. You'll be seeing today. Amen.
Mm-hmm.
The giants in the Bible. We'll check it this afternoon. and we continue in the prayer. Amen?
Amen.
We said before, if you look at 2 Samuel 21 from verse number 15, 2 Samuel 21 from verse number 15, it talks about more giants in the Bible. We talk about it from 15 to 22. Amen. 2 Samuel 21:15-22. I'll take my reading from here. When the Philistines were at war again, does the Bible have again? When the Philistines were at war again with Israel. That means the first time they were destroyed, Goliath was destroyed by David. And again, they went into war again with the Israel. So, beloved, we are not permitted to rest. Say, I'm not permitted to rest.
I'm not permitted to rest.
I beg you in the name of God. I will say, people, I don't force people to come to church. But when you come to church, know where you come from. Amen.
Amen.
When the Israelites had rested, when God has showed himself in the life of the Philistines, of the Israelites against the Philistines, that they saw a small boy destroy a giant, that they all believed, the head of their army. The Bible says they ran away those days. And they went to fortify themselves again. And they came back to trouble the Israelites again. That means, children of God, you are not permitted to relax. Say, I'm not permitted to relax.
I'm not permitted to relax.
When the Philistines were at war again with Israel, David and his servants with him went down and fought against the Philistines. And David grew faint. Is that your Bible? David, a man of God, he grew faint. He was tired. Then Ishbi-Benob, who was one of the sons of the giants, the weight of whose bronze spear was 300 shekels, who was bearing a new sword, thought he could kill David. But Abishai, the son of Zeruiah, came to his aid and struck the Philistine and killed him. What does it mean to us? After David had conquered Goliath at the first instance, David became the head of the army. He became the king. He became the overall commander. But the Philistines again arose with war. And when they arose with war, the Bible says, and David grew faint. Beloved, what does faint mean? That is, you that were very powerful before, you became someone that had no power. He that was very strong before became someone that had no power. Beloved, what is sapping our power as Christians? I said it before, many of us, when we watch films, our voices are so loud. When we pray, we talk, when we play around with our friends, we suck loud. But when it comes to the house of prayer, that is when devil will come and attack. That is when we feel like sleeping. That's why we are complaining, we are tired. The moment the church is finished, the same person that was tired in the church will be the person running about on the street. You have to be very careful. We have to be very, very careful. Have you ever wondered that it is in the church that we feel very tired? I used to do Shiloh here before, and we do it under my brother, the basement of my house. During Shiloh, you will seldom see people pray. But the moment Shiloh is over, you see them upstairs. It's their voice so loud. And one day I called them together, I told them, I said, listen, if you want to come and play with me as a friend, come on a separate day, not Shiloh day. Whenever you are here on the Shiloh day, you have come for prayer. But you want to come here and play, you can come from days that is not Shiloh. I will entertain you with prayer, with playing. But when it comes to days of prayer, I don't play. Some went away and did not come back, and I have not missed them till now. Before, we do Shiloh day 12 to 2, I'm talking about 7-8 years ago. So 6-7 years ago. We did Shiloh day 12 to 2. Some people will not come for Shiloh. When it's 5 minutes or 10 minutes to up to finish it, that's when they will come. Then they will not sit down with us till about 6 o'clock. And one day I called them. I said, enough. This place is not a place of prayer or playing. This is a place of prayer. Listen, when you are doing right, you don't need people to sing your praises. Some people went away. Don't bother about them. If they are yours, they will come back. I know the whole world is listening to me today, but I want us to learn. Many of us, the children will not disturb you when you are at home. When you come to the house of prayer, that's when the children will be disturbing you. No! No, 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 no. The house of prayer is the house for destiny renewal. The house of prayer is the house of destiny renewal. This is not a place to be apologetic. We can understand what is happening of recent. I'll speak to one of my sisters previously. Some people did not have COVID. They only have mind sickness. That is why the hospital is telling you don't come for any mind sickness. They will ask you your symptoms. What is your symptoms like? This is at the symptom. They will ask you when you tell the symptoms. When you say it's not, they say call your GP. Don't go to any hospital. Because some people went to the hospital without COVID. They go to the hospital, they got infected with COVID, and they died. Beloved, the house of prayer is the house where you must be serious with God. The house of prayer is the house where you must be serious with God. This is not a place to come and play. Hey, we never play our destinies away. You may not like it, you may not like me. I said it to many people ago before. They did not like some of them wait, some of them waited. I'm not looking for people that will not make heaven. I want people that will make heaven. Look at what is happening here. The Bible says, and David grew weak. The same David that was fighting and winning battles. 2 Samuel 21 from 15. See, when the Philistines were at war again, that means the enemy will never rest. They came back again. They have no way you will be sleeping. They know where you will not be serious. Do you understand? Why do you think it is when we sleep at night that the enemies come to attack? Because that is when we are what? That is when we are vulnerable. The most difficult punishment that the military give their captors is they deprive them of sleep. They don't need to beat them. But when they deprive somebody of sleep for 5 days, they know it is greater punishment. God has not molded us like that. So because when we sleep, we are vulnerable. The Bible said, hallelujah, and David and his servants went down and fought with the Philistines. And David grew faint. If you have your Bible there, please underline that word, grew faint. What does the meaning of grew faint? How will somebody grow faint? David became tired. He became tired. He was old. Tiredness can come for old age. Tiredness can come when there are many things that is happening. Amen.
Amen.
Tiredness can come due to overwork. That is where they always tell people that, please, when you come to church, if you have to take an energy drink, take it. Don't be tired at place of prayer. Because that is when the enemy can attack. Oh, pastor is advocate for energy drink. Yes, as far as it's going to have to alcohol, take it and be active for prayer. Be active for prayer. David grew faint. That could have been an error of his life. Do we understand what I'm saying? Let us see verse 16. Then Ishbi Benob, who was one of the sons of the giant. Can you imagine? He was one of the sons of the giant. The weight of his bear, of his bronze bear, was 300 shekels. Wow. He was bearing a new sword. Thought, wow, this is the opportunity to what? To strike David and kill David. Enemies are waiting for opportunities. What is, as he was thinking about that, opportunity, who was bearing a new sword, thought he could kill David. But Abishai, thank God for people of destinies. Abishai, the son of Zeruiah, came to David's aid. May people come to your aid in the name of Jesus. So when we talk to people at church, they say, the pastor talks too much, father, he abuses too much. Yes, let me tell you. May we not die at the place of destiny. If not for Abishai, David could have gone. But Abishai, the son of Zeruiah, came to his aid. I want us to pray. We need an Abishai that will come to our help in the time of our vulnerability. Do we understand? I want us to pray. Say, Father, send me an Abishai that will come to my help when I am needing help. When I am vulnerable, begin to pray, Father, send me an Abishai. Send me an Abishai. Father, send me an Abishai. David did not know anything. He was already faint. He was almost going. The enemy was almost striking him. But thank God for Abishai, the man of knowledge, the man of wisdom, the man of the man that knows that this is going to happen to our commander. And the Abishai came and destroyed the giant. Beloved, hear me very well. David may not know, he may even be backing. He has grown faith. Yes, David was a friend of God. But the friend of God is a woman being. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Jesus even said, the spirit is willing, but the flesh is weak. He grew faith. What can cause somebody to grow faith? One, if you are in sin, in a place of holiness. What have I just said?
If you are in sin,
in a place of holiness, you have been nothing. The Bible says, when we are sinning, we are not a friend of God. He that sin is not of God. For the Father Satan sins. Hallelujah. The Bible said that when Samson, his ear of strength, his anointing has been shaved off. Hallelujah. He did not know. The Bible said, and he said, I will go up and fight again. But by that time, the strength had gone. When we are in sin, when we are vulnerable, when we are not being steadfast, when we allow the things of the world to roll us away, beloved, we are fainting. No matter how strong you are as a Christian, David was a friend of God. He could have ended his career. Can you hear me? Let's continue. Struck the Philistines and killed him. Then the men of David, they swore to him, saying, David, you shall no more go out with us to the battle. Is it in your Bible? Let us read it together. Hallelujah, let's read it together. Verse 17. Are you there? Lest you quench the lamp of Israel. That is why I will not allow it. When people come to that's a prayer and then they are sleeping. I used to have a woman that comes to church before. She is always sitting there. I say, no. What did yeah, let us read it in the Bible together. What did they say? They said, then the men of Israel, the men of David, swore to him, said, sir, you shall no more go out with us to battle, lest you will quench the lamp of Israel. Hey, somebody, when you pray with somebody that has no zeal, it kills your spirit. Somebody listening to me.
Oh, yes.
So when somebody is sitting there, pastor says, stand up. Don't pray with people that has no fire in there. I don't care if you want to stay at home. I'm not going to waste my time before God. anointed. You are not there. My father in the Lord. I heard him yesterday. Anybody that I see that is doing well for God is my father in the Lord. Pastor Elinche. He said, hear me. He said, 100 lion, and then lion. He said, 100 sheep led by one lion. Hear me. 100 sheep led by one lion would destroy 100 lion led by one sheep. Does it make sense to you? 100 sheep behind, but it's one lion that is roaring, and 100 lion behind, it is one sheep that is leading. Say that 100 sheep with one lion will destroy the 100 lion that has one sheep leading them, because the crowd will follow the leader. What does it mean? That the one that if the sheep that is coming to face, sheep that has 100 lion behind it, is coming to face the lion that had 100 sheep. The mind of the sheep, mindset of the sheep, is that there are other lions behind that sheep. So sheep will do what? Will run. And the one behind did not know what way is running. They also run. So when you are in a place leading, don't be a sheep leading lions. And don't be a lion leading sheep. Be a lion leading lion, hallelujah, so that you can destroy anything that comes before you. Don't be like people that will just hear, see people running and just running. Ask them what is pursuing them. If you are spending 1 hour with the Lord, just 1 hour must be on fire. Say, must be on fire.
Must be on fire.
They told David, you are no more going to war with us, so that you don't put off the lamp of Israel. 8, number 13. Now it happened afterward. There was again a battle with the Philistines at God. The Sibekai, the Ushanite, killed Sap, who was again one of the sons of the giants. I pray with you, whosoever giant that is tormenting your family, tormenting your ministry, tormenting your life, tormenting your children, to them mark their hand in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Verse 19. Again, there was war at Go with the Philistines, where Elhanan, the son of Jareh or Gagin, the Bethlehemite, killed the brother of Goliath the Gittite, the brother. So we have many giants. Some giants are not yet putting their heads up. They are still hiding. The moment their leaders are gone, they want to show face. I pray with you, the anointing that will destroy giants. Giants molesting your life. Jump up and say, I receive in the name of Jesus.
In Jesus' name.
Anointing that people will hear about, they begin to run.
Amen. Jesus.
Are you getting it? Anointing that they will see your children and they begin to flee.
Amen. It's a nice name.
Hear me. The child of a snake is a snake. The child of a snake is a snake. The poison in giving a big snake is only the poison within a small snake. So you are not permitted to be molested.
Amen.
You know what you carry. Say, I know what I carry.
I know what I carry.
Say, I carry grace.
I carry grace.
No, please. I'm not, maybe as at times hard on you. I'm hard because I want us to make everything together. You must know our life must not be wasted. Amen.
Amen.
Can you see many giants being killed? Hey! Not maybe they don't only kill giants. There are many people that kill giants. Amen.
Amen.
Yet again, verse 20. Yet again, there was another war at Gat, where there was a man of great stature. Are you seeing it? Mm-hmm. Verse 20. Verse 20. Mm-hmm. 2 Samuel 21, verse 20.
Yeah.
There was a man there of great stature, who had this one, the Bible did not even mention his name. This one was extraordinary. Mm-hmm. The Bible says he has six foot and six fingers. There are giants still hiding. Today, God destroyed them in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Hear me? Yet again, he had 6 fingers on each hand and 6 toes on each foot, 24 in number, and he was born toward to the giants. 21. When he defied Israel, oh, you are not permitted to be defied.
Amen.
Bible said, when he defied Israel, Jonathan, the son of Shimea, his brother killed him. These four were born to the giants in Gath. You are not permitted to allow any giant molesting you to live. Somebody needs to say amen to that.
Amen.
Whosoever is that giant tormenting your existence in life, they will not see tomorrow in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Rise up with me. We're going to pray for the next 20, 25 minutes. So I want you, as you are praying, be jumping around. Say, Father, I thank you. For your hand will deliver me.
For your hand will deliver.
Begin to pray, Father, in the name of Jesus. I thank you, Lord.
Father, I thank you.
That your hand will deliver me. Father, we deliver my children. Remember, this is the hour of prayer for our children. As you pray for yourself, pray for your children. Father, I thank you. That your hand will deliver me, deliver my children.
Deliver my
home, deliver my ministry. In the name of Jesus.
Lord,
yes. Father, I thank you,
Lord,
that you will deliver me. I will stay under your protection.
Father, I thank you.
Father, I will not misbehave again.
Father, Lord,
your hand will deliver me. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray.
Amen.
I want to surprise my sister, raise up the hand. I had the voice of God. Father, help me. Begin to pray, Father, in the name of Jesus.
Father, help me.
My strength cannot continue.
My strength cannot continue.
Raise your hand to God and say, Father, help me.
Father, help me.
Jesus, help me.
Jesus, help me.
Help my children. Anyone that says I will not make it, Father, take them away. Every power wasting my destiny, take them off.
Every power wasting my destiny.
In Jesus' name, we pray.
Lord, destroy them.
You remember Jeremiah 17:18 that we read before? Mm-hmm. We are talking about it. He said, you will not be put to shame.
Amen.
But your enemy shall be put to shame.
Amen.
I want us to pray, say, Father, in the name of Jesus.
Father, in the name of Jesus.
According to your word.
In Jeremiah 17, verse number 18.
That I will not be put to shame.
That I will not be put to shame.
And I will not be dismayed. But my enemies. The Goliaths after my life. They will be put to shame. They will be dismayed. And be destroyed. Begin to pray, Father, in the name of Jesus. According to the word. In Jeremiah 17, verse 18. Yes. That I will not be put to shame. Father, honor your word.
Yes.
Yes. Honor your word. Honor your word. Honor your word. Honor your word. Let my enemies be put to shame. In the name of Jesus. Let my enemies be put to shame. In the name of Jesus. Every power that is molesting me, let them be put to shame. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
They took that woman to Jesus Christ. They said they caught her in adultery. And Jesus said, who out of you has not committed such? Let that person strike the first stone. The Bible says, and no one could stone it. So now, and they all walked away. And Jesus looked at her. He said, where are your accusers? He said, I see them no more. Say, me also, I do not accuse you. I want us to pray. Say, Father, in the name of Jesus.
Father, in the name of Jesus.
All my accusers.
And the accusation.
Father, destroy them.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen. Somebody, a woman needs to pray that prayer. What has been stopping you from going forward are what your accusers are saying about you. You may know yourself. The accusers, that lady, that man, listen. But any accusers are my accusation. Father, destroy them and wipe them away. Pray that prayer.
Father, pray that prayer.
All my accusations. I cancel it in the name of Jesus.
Of my life.
In Jesus' name, we pray.
Amen.
I want us to know Everybody has a past life.
Mm.
Every of my past life that is haunting my present.
Every of my past life that is haunting my
present. Oh, pray that prayer very well. Maybe you've done something to somebody you don't know. And the past mistakes are haunting our present. That is a Goliath in our life. Every past mistake haunting my present.
Every past mistake.
I come against you in the name of Jesus. Begin to pray. Father, in the name of Jesus. Every past error. Every past mistake. Haunting my present. You are destroyed. You are destroyed. You are destroyed. Past error. I destroy you. Past mistake. I destroy you. Past error. I destroy you. Past mistake. I destroy you. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
Ah, accusers and accusations, they're so powerful. They can stand against somebody's children. And say, oh, you better don't help them. Oh. Hey, some people that helped them yesterday, they went into a problem. Accusers and accusations. Every child must have passed through. We all passed through, isn't it?
Oh, yes.
You may be a pastor today, you know the life you live. You may be a prophetess today, you know the life you live. If God was to open us and see as we come, you see people see our past errors, people will run for us. I want us to pray. That Lord, every accusation for my future.
Every accusation for my future.
Oh, what are you waiting for? Be destroyed finally today. Who's that person that accusing me? Who is that person that accusing my family? Who is that person destroying me? Yes, 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 yes. Father, destroy them. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
I was doing a Bible study maybe last month. There was a priest. The Bible says, and that man silently come to Jesus. The priest was, I forgot his name. He was one of the leaders of the temple. He was the one that, I remember Bible says, he was the one that they joined in carrying Jesus to go and bury. I forgot his name. No one. What I'm saying is that man, when they took Jesus and they asked him to is it, how will I get out there? They asked him to testify. The Bible says he did not testify. And the Bible says, and they were beating him. Oh my God, I can't remember that place. I know it's Acts. And they were, it's Acts of the, it was Acts of the Apostles. And they were beating because the man refused to testify against Paul. And they were beating this man. This man, because the Bible says he was the one that came, hold on, let me check it. He was the one that came to Jesus in the night. Are you getting it? Let's quickly check. Sit down for now. There's some things that I want us to know so we don't forget again. Hallelujah. Sit down for now. The man that came to Jesus at night. This man was a quiet. Oh my God. There are some accusers that wants to destroy. This man was a silent apostle of Christ. Was a silent follower of Christ. If you look at it, this man that came to Jesus at night. And look at his life. When he got the place, they wanted him to testify against all. His name was Nicodemus. God bless you. Nicodemus. Hallelujah.
Amen.
In John 3:2, said Nicodemus came to Jesus at night. And if I love, look, go to John. John 3:2. They said Nicodemus came to what? To Jesus. In John 3:2, verse 1 to 21. You don't have to read everything, but so write it down when you get home. You can read it. John 3, from 3 from 1 to 21, precisely 2, what does 2 say? And a certain lame, no, John 3, John, sorry, I'm reading, sorry. John 3, oh my God, I feel excited today. I can feel the hand of God upon somebody. John 3, verse 2. Okay, let's see from verse 1. There was a man of the Pharisees named Nicodemus, a ruler of what? Of the Jews. This man came to Jesus by night and said to him, Rabbi, we know you are a teacher from God, for no one can do these things you do except God is with him. Jesus answered and said to him, most assuredly, I say to you, unless one is born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God. He was the same man that asked Jesus, is it possible to go into the mother's belly and be born again? Are you getting my point? The same man that asked Jesus. And they said he knew what he was saying, but just when they just saw his passion. What did this man again? This man is what his accusers are talking about. Accusers. They punished him. Go to 7. Hallelujah. Hey, Bayaga Rabosheta. In John 7, when he got to John 7, this one could not come openly. And not knowing that there were some accusers against him. John 7. What did John 7 verse 1? Verse 50 to 51 say. John 7, 50 to 51. This man was quietly supporting Jesus. 50 to 51 said, Nicodemus, he who came to Jesus by what? By night. Being one of them, said to them, does our Lord judge a man before he hears him? When they brought these people to be judged, and said, why are you judging them? Don't let us, does our Lord judge a man before he speaks? He could not come out openly, but he was secretly coming. Hallelujah. He was secretly coming. Now let us see again. Now go to John 19. John 19, 39 to 42. See what happened there. See what we're talking about, accusers. John 19. Oh my God, I feel excited today that God is about doing new things. And he's already doing it in somebody's life. John 19, 39 to 42. Pastor, why are you talking? We are talking about, you are calling John. How do we know that this Nicodemus was part of people that carried Jesus? You will see it in John 19. In John 19 from verse 39. Let's read it to here. Let's read from here. And Nicodemus, is it in your Bible?
Yes.
And Nicodemus, who at first came to what? Came to Jesus at night. The first time he saw him, he went to Jesus. He went to meet Jesus at night. Also came, look at it again. The first time he went was to meet Jesus at night. Then when Jesus was killed, he also came, bringing a mixture of myrrh and aloes. This one wants to support him, wants to be a follower, but he doesn't want to be a follower openly. Are you getting it? He doesn't want to be a follower openly because he was a Pharisee. Not only a Pharisee, he was a member of the executive council. He was a member of Sanhedrin. He was a member of the Sanhedrin. And the Gospel of John mentioned it. John mentions them about three times. He was not just an ordinary person, but he was a secret follower. Beloved, if you want to be for God, be for God. So when you were judging the one of the apostles, say, why? What does our Lord say we condemn somebody without first hearing him? Hear me very well. The second time, when Jesus died, look at it. He said, verse 40. He said, okay, 39. And Nicodemus, who at first came to Jesus by night, also came bringing a mixture of myrrh and aloes, about 100 pounds. Those times, that's what they use in embalming. Are you getting my point? They use it to paint the dead body and they embalm. It does not decay. Are you getting my point? So he brought about 100 pounds. Beloved, 100 pounds is worth something. Look at me. I weigh 80 pounds. Just put me in a bag and carry me 80 pounds. You will know what I weigh. Talk less of this man bringing something worth 100 pounds just to cover Jesus and what? And embalm him. He was there with Jesus at the end, to the end. Hear me? Verse 40. Say, then they took the body of Jesus, bound it in strips in of linen with the spices, as the custom of the Jews is to bury them. That is the same Nicodemus. Amen. I pray with you as I pray with me that God will hear you today in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. God will hear you today in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
What am I saying? If you continue, you'll see what happened. There's a place in us. Let us quickly get that place. Maybe we're going to head very soon. But I'm still going to head the 1:15 today. It's going to be a powerful time. So let's continue. Okay. Let's see where Nicodemus was beaten. Oh my God.
Thank you, Jesus.
He was beaten by his people. Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Oh my God, I'm trying to see the place. I'm coming, we'll get there. At times when things come to me like this, I may not prepare it. Amen. Are you excited?
Yes.
Are you getting something today?
Yes.
Okay. get the place, but get it, I'll let you know. Mm-hmm. What I'm saying that we are talking about the accusers. People that accuses. People that mocks. Are you getting my point?
Oh, yes.
People that whatever one is doing, they tend to backstab people. May God deliver us from them in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Rise up into the door, continue praying. Say, Blood of Jesus.
Blood of Jesus.
Visit my foundation.
Visit my foundation.
I talked about the house you grew up. Hey, beloved, please pray this prayer. The house you grew up. Say, Father, in the name of Jesus.
Father, in the name of Jesus.
Visit the house I grew up.
Visit the house that I grew
visit
up.
Visit the compound I grew up.
Visit the compound that I grew up.
Visit the people that I grew up.
Visit the people I grew up.
Whatever has been taken from me.
Whatever has been taken from me.
Either buried or hung.
Either buried or
hung. Father, take them back to me. Begin to pray, Father, in the name of Jesus.
In the mighty name of
Jesus. Yes, yes, yes.
Father,
bring them back to me. 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 Whatever has been taken from me. Father, return that. This is my foundation. Yes, yes, return them back to me. Return them back to me. Yes, yes, yes. Yes, yes. Return them back to me. Yes, yes, return them back to me. Yes, yes, yes. Yes, yes, yes.
Every evil
yes, yes, yes.
Right in the right
in
the
right.
children.
The Lord silence
you.
Yes.
In the name of Jesus.
Yes. Yes.
Yes.
Yes. Destroy them.
Destroy them.
Yes.
Yes. In the name of Jesus.
Yes.
May the Lord
silence. Yes. 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 Yes.
Speaking evil about my children.
Any mouth. Destroying my children. Anybody.
Any council.
That are destroying my children. Physically or spiritually. Father, disgrace them.
Father, Lord,
silence them.
By power,
by
force. Begin
to pray.
Jesus.
Yes, yes, yes.
Name of Jesus.
Silence them.
Destroy my children. Any cancer.
Yes.
Destroy my children.
Yes.
Lord, silence
yes.
them. In the mighty
yes.
name of Jesus.
Any
Lord,
cancer.
Any cancer.
Yes.
Any mouth.
Yes.
Speaking evil against my
Jesus
children.
Lord,
not silence them.
We talked about many giants in the Bible.
Hmm.
Look at them. The moment the big giant died, every other one rose up.
Hmm.
I want us to pray. Every silent giant now.
Every silent giant.
That will later rise up. To trouble me. Father, destroy them.
Father, destroy them.
What am I saying? You are you saw a snake, and as you killed the snake, you now saw some little ones came out. Would you leave them?
No.
Why?
Because later day too they will be.
They will block us trouble. Maybe rat is infesting your house, and you are able to kill the mother rat or the big rat. You now see the children. Oh, these ones are little children. These ones are babies and mice. So let me leave them. I want us to pray. Every giant. Every stubborn Goliath.
Every stubborn Goliath.
Receive sudden death. Every children of Goliath.
That will torment me in the future.
Lord, destroy them today.
Every children of Goliath that will trouble me in future, Lord, destroy them today.
In Jesus' mighty name, we pray.
Amen.
Apologies, the man I was talking about is Sostesne, not Nicodemus.
Okay,
so it's Sostesne. You will see his story in the book of Acts 18. Sostesne is not Nicodemus. Sorry about that.
Acts 18.
From verse 12. I'm going to read it for you now. To 17.
Sostesne.
The name is a bit Sostenes. Sostenes. Okay, let me read it out to you. From Acts 18, from verse 12. When Gallio was proconsul of Achaia, the Jews, with one accord, rose up against Paul and brought him to the judgment seat, saying, This fellow persuades men to worship God contrary to the law. Worship God. He was the one that led them. He was the leader. And when Paul was about to open his mouth, Gallio said to the Jews, "It were a matter of wrongdoing or wicked crimes, O Jews, there would be no reason why I should bear with you. But if it's a question that should, if he said, if it were a matter of wrongdoing or wicked crimes, O Jews, there will be reasons why I should bear with you. But if it's a question of words and names and your own law book, look to it yourself, for I do not want to be a judge of such matters." And he drove them from the judgment seat. Hear me, hear what happened next. He said, if there's to be somebody of crime, I have to judge. But this one is about law. He said, if it were to be a matter of wrongdoing or wicked crimes, Jews, there will be reason why I should bear with you. Listen, everybody. But if it is a question of ordinary words and names and your own law, say, look to it yourself, for I do not want to be a judge of such matters. Verse 16. And Gallio drove them out of his judgment seat. Verse 17. Look at what happened there. You know, we are praying about cancer, isn't it?
Yeah.
We are praying about cancer and what people 17. Then all the Greeks that took part, the Greeks that took part of the king, what did they do? Every counsel and negative counselors, they will receive shame in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
We are talking about accusers and accusation. Mm-hmm. Now, when Gallo drove them out of the palace, verse 17, then they all the Greeks, what did they take? Mm-hmm. They took Sosthenes, the ruler of the synagogue, and they beat him before the judgment seat. They took the leader, the one that led them, and began to beat him. Mm-hmm. The Bible says, and Gallio took no notice. He just ignored it. That is, it's like yourself. I want us to pray that Lord, turn the counsel of my enemies. Turn it against themselves. Look at it. God turned their goals against themselves. They took Paul to be judged. But when they came, when they went there, God don't do them out. Instead of them fighting with Paul, they took their leader, began to beat their leader. They beat their leader. And Gallo did what Bible says, and Gallo took no notice. I want us to pray. The Lord cause a fight.
Cause a fight.
Within those gatherings. Against my family. Against my voice.
Against my life.
Cause a fight.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
As you cause a fight in the book of Acts 18. Name of Jesus.
Amen.
Today we're going to start our Bible class. But today, instead of 7, normally do it, it will be 6 to 7:30. I'm not sure if it will be televised, but whatever, what we normally do is we treat what that Adeboye treats every day. We discuss within ourselves and we analyze it together. I'm not sure if it's going to put online, but open the open heavens of today. Why are you using open heavens? I said before, I may not be a LCCG member, but I respect the anointing of our fathers in the Lord. Daddy Aboye Adeboye, I respect his anointing. Daddy Olukoya, I respect his anointing. Daddy Oyedepo, I respect his anointing. All those great men of God, I respect the anointing. So where we can learn, I go there. So we are using Daddy Adeboye's open heavens to teach ourselves. And by the grace of God, tonight, 6 to 7:30, we shall be doing the Bible class. If you're available, we might put the phone on, but I'm not sure about that. But just be on the lookout. I will see you. Let's share the grace in fellowship today. And the grace of Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit, be with us now and forever. Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our life, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. Thank you all for joining. Thank God for our media. The messages have been very, very, very good. The feedbacks I had on our Zoom, they can hear very well. Amen.
Amen.
And I see that the live is also very active. I will try and see, look a bit behind, check what has been happening on the live. I can see messages I may not be able to answer. And also our recording. If you cannot see everything, the main record, I'll put it on YouTube again. Go back and say it, and the Lord will bless you.
Amen.
I love you with the love of God. Amen. I will see you again tomorrow. Remember, tomorrow is Shiloh, 12 to 2. Let's all come together to glorify God. Amen. The Lord bless you and keep you. Make his face to shine upon you. Give us his unending blessings. Strengthen us. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. My sister just reminded me the motto of the church.
Run from sin.
Let's remember it all the time. The motto of the church.
Run from sin.
I want us to be able to get to a level that if you cannot run from sin, you cannot come to this ministry. It will, once you are saying it, you are putting fire on the head. May we never put power fire on our head.
Amen.
So if you are ready to run from sin, yes, we will work together. The motto of the church.
Run from sin.
Grace to run from sin God will give to us.
Amen.
I appreciate you all. The Lord bless you. Amen. Keep us and make his face to shine upon us.
Amen.
In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
Amen.